The concept was to make it something more than just a horse show, to make it a celebration of the Egyptian Arabian horse. There was not the technology that's available today, so it was very important for the breeders to have a place to showcase their horses and therefore bring their best horses. And at that time, the park was also just getting established, so it was decided to have this as the Mecca for these Egyptian Arabian horses to come and have an opportunity to celebrate the breeders and also the beginning of this showcase for the Egyptian Arabian horse.
I think the Egyptian event is special. First of all, the horse park is the most unique location for anybody that loves horses in the world. It's the only living horse museum with a horse of every breed, the whiteboard fences, when you pull into Lexington, it's all about horses. The facility itself is absolutely amazing, and it lends to the feel of the show. It always has. For many years, that paddock right behind you, John Henry would come and greet us every year when we'd pull in. And it was a sad day when we pulled in here and he wasn't in that paddock. So the park itself is just lends to such a classy feeling of something that is more than a show.
I look at the Egyptian event as a community of people that come together with a common passion, which is their love of the Egyptian Arabian horse. What I visualize would have happened in the desert where there were a gathering of tribes and they all got together. And during that time, not only did they make acquaintances with each other, but they shared their horses and the breeding that they had been doing. And everybody was able to see what was going on within the horses and still connect with each other.
We like to call it a celebration of the Egyptian horse. It celebrates the spirit and the uniqueness of the Egyptian Arabian horse. And we do a lot more than just have classes. Classes are fun and they're important and everybody has a good time watching the futurity horses and they get to see the new upcoming stallions and they get to see the bloodlines and how programs evolve and everything. But we also have a lot of educational seminars. There's educational seminars actually every day. We have programs. We have a gala, which is a terrific social event. And it showcases a terrific premier art auction.
From the onset, the Pyramid Society has always been most fortunate to be involved with some of the world's most talented artists. I think the fact that the Arabian horse lends itself to this incredible art. We have so many artists who say, you know, if I'm an artist, the horse I want to paint is the Arabian horse. So we've always been so very fortunate to have some of the most incredible worldwide artists who volunteer their talents and their time to help support this Egyptian event and the Pyramid Society. It's a wonderful, wonderful testimony to this really, really incredible horse.
This started out as a breeder's show. In fact, in 1969, when the founders founded the Pyramid Society, there wasn't obviously an Egyptian event. And so the first Egyptian event that they set out to create was exactly that. It was strictly a place for them to showcase their efforts in breeding, and thus that was the formation to begin with of the futurities.
The level of quality is always very, very high. We have some of the best Egyptian Arabians in the country competing, and also some from international. We have also international breeders and competitors.
You look around the ring, you see all the top handlers in the world here. You can actually win more prize money at an Egyptian event with a couple horses than you can at U.S. Nationals with a big string. The prize money is excellent. Yesterday we won the two breeders challenge of $21,000 per class. So the prize money per horse competing is absolutely excellent.
Tonight we have the championship classes where the colts, the fillies, the mares and stallions are competing. for different titles this year as we did last year. We're doing something just a little bit different in that we're crowning a gold champion, a silver, and a bronze champion in each division. So it's very exciting, and we can see how they stack up against each other tonight.
This is my first Egyptian event, and I have to say it's been a terrific experience. The show has been a real education for us, because it is our first show, and we're in our very early stages as Arabian horse owners and breeders to be able to experience the show, which is much different than many of the other shows that we've been to.
The show is and has always been terrific on the camaraderie. That's probably one of the highlights of this. If you think about it, we all have a common goal in what we breed, and yet we're scattered around the country. And in many instances, some of these people are our best friends out there, that we share a bond, a very unique bond, and there's a lot of social aspect to this. This is one time a year that we can all look forward to, that we can see each other, we can see, catch up, see what they're doing with their horses, they see what we're doing with ours, we can spend time, we can support each other, we can cheer that breeding program on, they can cheer our breeding program on. It is a unique opportunity, I think, to get together and support a type of horse. You know, the competition is there and it's friendly, but I think that it's done in a manner in which it's really more of still a broader base of support for the horse.
Why Straight Egyptians? It's because their history is so very special, and because there have been for hundreds and hundreds of years, probably thousands, keepers of this breed. And they seem to connect with people in a way that I find very intriguing. And they bring people together from all parts of the world, all walks of life, and this common love of the breed is just a really unifying force. And there's an energy around that that's very special.